applications for other US motor parks. And okay, so I say what's the US motor park for Blue IT? One of the world's largest online e-commerce retail operations for automotive parts. We do all of our software development and all of the delivery. So my history is our quality application is not correct for US motor parks. I used to work at companies like Yahoo, the so I worked with lots of large software teams and design developers, and I was asked to come here to the Philippines to help build up management teams and software teams here in the Philippines, much more than what I think. I'm British, I'm not American, that's my background. Okay, so about USAP, we are the most online retailer of we're the most successful online retailer of automotive replacement parts. And basically in the US, there's been a shift towards using the internet to get replacement parts for your car. And we are the people that are top of that game. There are companies that are bigger than us in the automotive parts business, but as far as online is concerned, we're number one. All of our web development and design is born here in the Philippines. We have a large installation at CyberGate, which is in aluminium. And as well as doing online retail sales, we've got a number of content portals on with our tools and videos and information about how to repair your car, how to find faults in it, and things like that. Again, all developed here in the Philippines. So many of the products weren't actually just built here in the Philippines, they were actually conceived and designed here in the Philippines as well. So we're making use of the ingenuity and the technical skills of the Filipino engineers that we have here to produce world-class products. Whilst we're on the subject of that, we've got a shameless advertising market here. We're hiring at the moment. We're looking for 10 new engineers, and we're looking for 20 more engineers next year. So we're always looking for good quality software engineers to do fast with our operation. Okay, so I'm going to give a brief rundown of the BPO industry in the Philippines, business process outsourcing industry. It's one of the fastest growing industry sectors in the world. Since 2006, it's grown by 46% in the Philippines year on year. And that is also in Wikipedia. The Philippines is ranked number one in the availability of knowledge for its jobs and workers, and number four amongst quality of labour. And it's mainly due to the flexible English-speaking workforce that exists here with good educational qualifications that student growth is into. My particular area obviously is software development. And software development is only a small part of the EDO industry at this moment, but it's actually growing very, very fast. Some key points here is things like media production and animation, which is specifically part of software development, is effectively the Philippines leads the world in our area. In terms of outsourcing, Philippines is not one good explanation for that. Software development next to India is also becoming one of the big areas for businesses that are actually moving their operations to the Philippines itself. Again, my own company used to do all this software development in the US, but we have now shifted everything over to the Philippines. However, there is a minor issue with the way in which development is done currently in a number of companies at the moment, which is that they're operating in what we call the command and control mode, which is where most of the management and project management of these projects are actually done outside of the Philippines, and the Philippines is effectively used as a software factory. But that is changing really, really fast. And you know, they're still there to unleash all the creativity and the raw technical skill that exists here on Philippine engineers. Okay, government has a number of initiatives on it. One of the key ones is the Philippine Software Industry 2010 Flight Plan, which is a project to be put together to actually promote Philippine software development skills and IT skills to the rest of the world. I'm not going to read through the entire slide here, but you can see there's a number of organizations that are actually engaged in that. Many of the clearly this is in the area of promoting the skill sets and the companies themselves to potential outsource clients, but also in the area of setting up certification standards here in the Philippines, setting up courses and things like that, to provide certification for Filipino engineers. Quick rundown of the competition the Philippines is competing with. In Asia, you've got South Korea, India, Vietnam, Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore. In many of these cases, they're strong English-speaking countries as well, so that plays very well in the software industry. China has the potential to be a very big competitor as well, but at the present moment, there are a number of cultural and language issues that means it's actually not a major player in the area. In Europe, the Eastern European countries are becoming big players in the software development arena. In South America, countries such as Chile, Argentina, Brazil, and Uruguay are now starting to come up as well. Russia is obviously starting to offer services too. South Africa is another area where we're seeing the emergence of a lot of services being offered from there. So basically, there's good strong backing for government, there's engagement with most top industry trade groups. It's mostly, as I say, targeted on promoting company capabilities, company skills, the BDO industry. It's also building the education and some of the qualifications that are required. But the goals are actually relatively medium term to long term, there's no really short term benefits involved here. So this is the way I'm going to make important point in my talk here. I really wanted to not talk about companies, I wanted to talk about you guys as individuals, about how you can contribute to actually selling Philippine technical skills to the world itself. It's not really much use waiting for someone to set up a program, set up an initiative or anything like that at all. You should be out there selling your capabilities, you uniquely, to the rest of the world itself. You have to be able to join into the community that operates online. I know that it tends to be a little insular at that time, so we have to actually engage in that and actually communicate with people in order to be noticed. We have this concept in Europe of creating your own personal brand. You have to think of yourself as a product. So you have to brand yourself and think about where you want to be. If you recall back at Albert Street, you were talking about setting a long-term goal, so you need to decide accordingly what kind of job or what kind of skills you want to present to the world, and you have to brand yourself on your product. You need to be visible in the places where other software development engineers, software development companies are hanging out with them on the net itself. If you're not visible to them, then you don't exist as far as I'm concerned. You need to be passionate about what you do. You need to be, you need to show your skills, you need to show your discoveries, you need to show the things that you are keen on, the things that you feel passionate about. You need to do all of this in English, unfortunately, because the software industry worldwide operates in English. If you don't operate in English, then you won't have any visibility at all. The other thing that you need to be careful of as well is that the employers are increasingly looking at what's called your footprint online. This is the amount of presence that you have on the internet itself. They will often look to see what kind of presence you have on the internet in order to see what kind of quality of person you are as an engineer or a contributor or an innovator. And with that, there's a word of caution, because I know a lot of you guys are actually using social networking sites and other sites that are actually posting information online. You have to be very, very careful about what you put in on these online social networks in the early stages of your career. You have to think about words, everything that you put online, what will that look like for a future or prospective employer? Because they are going to be looking at Facebook, they're going to be looking at Twitter, they're going to be looking at all these other places. You want to see what you look like as an individual. So you have to be really, really careful about that. One of the things about the internet is it's virtually impossible to erase information once it's actually been put out there. So you have to have a little bit of caution in that area. One of the things that's happened in the last 10 years is the emergence of the automotive industry. And one of the things that this is on is it's kind of a reset deck as far as the ability of small groups of people or individuals to compete in large companies. Anybody that owns a laptop can own virtually the same software and development tools and the same development methods that the large companies use to produce their software. But it kind of levels playing field a little bit. You can be running the very latest software without any having to pay any money for it at all, because it's all available online, downloaded and created on the internet. And these are the same products that the large organizations are used to build their own offerings. So you personally and individually can compete with large companies. One of the things I would consider as a job engineer is getting involved in an open source project. It's a fantastic way to learn how to develop software. It's a fantastic way to get you introduced to the world of online collaboration. It teaches you a lot about modern software techniques, management source control, various other things that you'll need later on in your professional career. And it's a good way of getting introduced to the open source and the community outside of things. Many of our open source project teams will provide newcomers with what's called mentors. A mentor is someone who will take on learning, show you how to do things, teach you how to actually release code and update code and everything like that. So again, it's a fantastic way of learning about yourself. The other thing you need to do is you need to engage in the conversation going on around the products you're using. So you need to get involved with the user groups, the IRC conversations, the message boards, things like that, that revolve around each of the individual technologies that you might use. And that's not a good way of getting visibility out there. Blogging. I hope most of you are blogging if you're going to software engineer. Because blogging is the fastest and most efficient way of getting visibility outside of this country. Right? So the more you blog, the more you're picked up by search engines, the more traffic is driven to your blog site, the more people notice what you're doing. Right? It is very much the fastest way of doing it. And if you're going to blog, I would encourage you to blog in English, again, because the rest of the world operates in English. Write about things that you've discovered, write about interesting things that you found, write about problems that you've solved, write about new software that you've noticed or seen.
Blog, right? Blog.
This all gets noticed and people will start conversing with you.
No, it's blog.
Okay, social media. And I gave a warning earlier on about using social media. That's a positive aspect as well. Again, social media is one of the best ways of getting discovered. But you need to be very, very sensible about using it. So there's a couple of services like LinkedIn, and I don't know if you guys are actually familiar with this. This is kind of the Facebook for professional users. It's very worthwhile getting yourself an account on LinkedIn, filling in your work experience, details, and information about what you want to do. For example, the last three jobs that I had came off LinkedIn. And most software professionals around the world are finding it being a very rich resource for actually getting contact with the industry. So to summarize this, Philippines is emerging as a very strong software development destination for companies. And it's growing very, very well, but it still has a very, very long way to go, right? And it's more to do with getting you guys personally getting more visible to the rest of the world. So the rest of the world has more confidence in Filipino engineers to deliver solutions for them efficiently. Government and industry is actively promoting, but it's really down to you guys. You are the grassroots of the industry itself. Most of you are going to be the future software developers, managers, program managers, project managers in this business. So you have to have personal visibility outside of that outside of it. And you need to engage the worldwide development community. The only conversation with them and making sure they're all seen and heard.
Okay.